Welcome back to Frappe Academy. So far we have seen how we can do basic data entry in my ERPNext account. To be able to make full use of the system, I need to migrate my existing data into ERPNext. So all the customers, suppliers, products, sales and purchase transactions of Frappe Furniture would need to be migrated to my ERPNext account. In this video, we will tell you how we are going to import our existing data to our account using spreadsheets quite easily. So let's get started. We will be importing all my items to the system. The item form contains some fields. These are actually the details of the item, like the brand, the standard selling rate, inventory details, default sales and purchase details, and so on. Watch our previous video on item creation for details. We will follow these steps to import all my existing items to my ERPNext account. The first step here is to select the document type in the data import. In this case, we will select item. Then I have to select the action, whether it is to insert new records or update the existing ones. This also means that even when you are pretty settled with ERPNext and have been using it for years, you can always update the records in bulk using the second option whenever you want. There is a checkbox that allows you to disable email notifications. Let's say when you create a quotation, you have set up a notification that will send an email to the customer. Now, while importing data, if you import a few hundred or thousand quotations, an email will be sent after each quotation is created. This behavior can be disabled using that checkbox. You can save the data import. There are two ways to import data. I can either download the template and upload the data in an Excel or CSV file or use Google Spreadsheets instead. We will see both the ways one by one. In the next step, I will click on Download Template, wherein I can select the fields for which I wish to add the data to my item records. The first option is the export type. Here, you can either select all the records or select only particular records by applying filters. You can also have only 5 records exported. The first 5 created in the system shall be exported if you select this. The last option is to export a blank template. I will select the first option and export all records, which I can use as reference for adding more data. Also, I can update the existing items by editing their data as well while importing the new records. Next, I have an option to select whether I want to export the data in CSV or Excel format. I will go with CSV. In the next step, I will select the fields that I want to add data to. All the mandatory options are selected by default here. Next, you can choose to manually select the field that you want to add. I will select some of the fields here, like item name, maintained stock, standard selling rate, etc. You can also select the field from the tables. Once that is done, I will export the file. This becomes the next step in this process. Adding the entries to the downloaded spreadsheet will be the step after this. Let me open the downloaded file. Here, every column represents a field that we just selected. The first column is item code that I've already added for the wooden wardrobe. I will add a similar item code for all the other entries. Before going ahead, let me add the item name for all the items. Since I'm going to be adding items that I may sell as well as purchase, I will add item groups accordingly. Here, I will have to ensure that I add item groups as what we have in ERPNext. Any other item group will not be accepted and my import will fail. Ensure that the measurement units for the UOM that you select here is a valid UOM in the system. Except for plywood and repairing service, everywhere else, the UOM will be in numbers. For plywood, it is going to be square foot, and for repairing service, it will be hours. Then comes maintained stock. This is a check field type. Year 1 means the checkbox is enabled, and 0 means the checkbox is disabled. So for repairing service, maintained stock would be 0, and for everything else, it will be 1. Then comes the standard selling rate. Let me add it one by one. Now we will add barcodes for the item. Since this is a child table, each new entry of the table, that is barcode, will be added in a new row. The new item can be added in a row after that. Once all the data is added to the CSV file, I will go back to the data import record and attach this file. This is the next step in the data import process. Once this is done, I can start importing the data into the system. When I do this, we can see that the system is showing an error. I added a wrong item group here and hence the system has shown a warning. I will correct the wrong entries in the CSV file and attach it again. Since I do not see any errors and warnings, I can go ahead with the import. This is the last step in the data import process. The duplicate records will be rejected by the system and the rest of the entries will be imported. New items are created. The status of the data import will be shown here as successful, partial success or pending. We can also export the errored files or go to the item list to check out the imported items. If I open an item, I can see the details that I added in the CSV file. If you scroll to the end, you can see a remark that this item was created via data import. The barcode table will also be populated with the data added. Now I will try the second method, that is using Google Sheets. I can use the same downloaded template and all the headers will be mapped accordingly. I will create a few entries here. I will copy the URL of the spreadsheet to this section in the import. If I face any errors, I can change them in the spreadsheet and click on Refresh Google Sheet. The new changes will appear. I can simply click on the Start button to have the data imported and the import can be completed. A fairly simple process wherein I don't have to re-upload the sheet in case of corrections. Clicking on the Refresh button will do the job. Similarly, you can import the data for any other doc type in the system using any of the above ways. It is recommended that you make a couple of entries manually before trying out the data import. Data import can also be used to update the existing data. We hope that this video helped you import all your existing data in ERPNext. You can refer to the user manual for in-depth information and feel free to reach out to us for any assistance if required. Do comment to let us know your thoughts on the video and don't forget to subscribe to ERPNext.